exciting to see everyone here. I cannot think of a better time to get together with family and friends and laugh and sing, which I promise you will do tonight, than right now. And there is one word that I can think of that wraps up why we're meeting tonight. And I don't know if you guys know what it is, but I'm going to put it up here on the screen. And I want you to shout it out with me. One, two, three. They're so good. They listen so amazing. Thank you. It makes me feel so good when people listen. Okay, so joy. So what is joy? Okay, it might be a word that you see next to an angel or a nativity scene. I think of the little girl with blue hair on Inside and Out, and she's happy all the time. So joy means a lot of different things to a lot of different people, but we define it this way. It's up here. Say it with me. That is so right. And we're going to be talking about that a little bit more. So joy is basically having happiness that doesn't have to be connected to what's going on around you right at that moment. So you can be tired and still have joy. You can be hungry somehow. I'm trying to figure that out and still have joy. Working on it. You can be sick and still have joy. And I think it's so important to remember at Christmas time, because as much fun as we like to have, sometimes things can go wrong, right?
Sometimes? Did you say sometimes things can go wrong at Christmas? Did I hear you correctly?
This is my co-host Peter Moore, everybody!
Sometimes. Did you really say sometimes?
You could say hi to everyone. Hello, leave me hanging.
Oh.
Thank you.
This place is full of families.
Yes.
What are we gonna do?
We're gonna do Jingle Jam, what we've been practicing for weeks. We're gonna get excited. Watch, they get really excited. Everybody. I told ya.
They've been hitting the eggnog early.
Okay.
You poor people.
What poor people?
Oh, these unsuspecting souls. You guys don't know how hard it can be at Christmas. Look, I hate always having to be the serious one around here, but I'm going to tell you all like it is. You have forced my hand.
Okay, Peter, yeah. Christmas is a time to celebrate. It's a time we get together with our family and our friends, and we laugh.
Bah humbug, okay? Christmas is the worst, all right? Traffic, it's terrible, right? The days, they keep getting shorter, right? Oh, and the weather. Here in Florida, it's practically freezing all the time.
Oh, it's so cold in Florida.
And the worst part of it all is the people standing on street corners asking me for money.
That's charities.
No, my relatives.
Okay. Peter. We were just talking about having joy no matter what's going on around you.
Oh, Stephanie, it's no use, okay? Christmas is just so bad. It's when everything is gonna go wronger-ish.
It goes wronger?
Okay, look, it's so bad I cannot even get my words out perfectly.
Oh, Peter, I see what you mean.
No. Terrible. You are going to see what I mean, and I've brought out a little hope. I'm actually really excited about this.
Wait a minute. What are you doing?
Oh, I brought out some guys to help. Come on out, guys.
No. This is not about pointing out a couple things that can go wrong at Christmas, and you cannot just take over.
Oh, when have I not taken over? All right. Hey, guys. Welcome. Thanks for coming. Oh, they're so cute. Oh, I love it. Oh, thanks for coming, guys. All right.
What in the world?
Oh, yeah. You're going to see now. Are you guys ready for this?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
I'm so sorry.
Oh, shipping fees, oh, shipping fees. How much will this gift cost me? I'm not a member of the prize, so all my orders take my dimes. Oh, shipping fees, oh, shipping fees. How much will this gift cost me?
Okay. That is one tiny little aggravation we can face at Christmas. But you did mention gifts. Gifts are something positive.
Oh, really?
It came upon a man. chia pet and smells like North Jersey shore.
Okay, that is not even true. Besides, getting gifts is not why we celebrate Christmas, right? We celebrate Jesus' birthday by giving gifts to others. That's a wonderful time to have a good time at Christmas.
Yeah. Okay, guys, can we just pause for a minute? Can I ask you all a question? Any of you guys ever have to put a gift together before you gave it? Did you? Oh, come on, don't be shy.
Okay, so,
you know it.
So they get the joy of preparing a gift for someone.
Oh, did you hear the snickers from these people? I heard you, sir. Oh, yeah. I heard you chuckle.
Don't encourage him.
Try and pretend I'm not pointing at you now. You know it was you. So handsome. Anyway, you have just heard that they're sitting in their room at night, okay? They're trying to figure out how to take 1,000 pieces and find part A and put it with part B, okay? They know batteries aren't included, right? Okay? And they're sitting on their floor at 11:30 at night, bleeding from paper cuts because they can't read the instructions that are in French! This song is for you.
These three things have so many parts. I'll need a wrench and then a crowbar. Cursing, fighting, thunder and lightning. The hair on my arm is charred. Oh, this is awful. This ain't right. I'll be working through the night. Kids are fleeting. I'll take a beating. It looks so easy on their website. All night long I stay awake. There's one more thing I'm hoping to make. Coffee is brewing. My brain starts spewing. My hand is starting to shake. The stove of mine, she giggles and wets. To get her to work, I think I need a vet. I've been reading directions this morning. I should have bought a pet.
This year, my son, he wants a toy car. This is what I've assembled so far. Wheels aren't turning, something is burning. Elves never work this hard.
Oh, this is awful, this ain't right. I'll be working through the night. Kids are fleeting, I'll take a beating. It looked easy on their website.
Oh, yeah.
Peter, I think I speak for everyone here when I say that that was
amazing. Amazing. I mean,
no.
Tears.
Stop it.
They're like
Peter,
streaming down my face, right?
No offense to these darling people, but that was terrible words to some wonderful songs about how wonderful Christmas is.
Oh, come on. You just don't understand how hard Christmas can be.
I think I do.
Oh, no. I think you will. Come along, gang. Follow me.
Okay. Honestly, I am sorry for his attitude. He really is a great guy, and he really does love Christmas. Maybe he needs some cheering up. Can you guys help me do that later? Will that be okay? Okay, good. Thought I was gonna have to do this by myself. That would be terrible. So I'm gonna go get something set up really quick while you enjoy a quick word from our sponsor who wants to help anybody having a tough Christmas season.
Some assembly required. Lights out. Fruitcake. Is Christmas here but you can't find your holiday cheer? Well, you can still find a way to be happy.
But how?
Introducing the Bodazzler from the same company that brought you the bologna ornament. You can make finding your joy this Christmas as easy as 1, 2, 3. Can't find the right gift for the grandpa who has everything? Bodazzle him! Beta fish, not quite the pet you want? Bodazzle it! Have you been over the river and through the woods, but the kids still can't behave on the way to Grandma's? Bodazzle them!
I can be happy this Christmas! I'll just put a bow on it!
Well, you can now. You have the Bodazzler. Available anywhere fine prevarications are sold. Not available in Hawaii or New Hampshire or any of the other states or nations in the northern or southern hemispheres. All uses in this commercial have been simulated. All people in this commercial have been simulated. All products in this commercial have been simulated. All the simulations have also been simulated. Bodazzler. Get yours today and put a bow on it.
Thanks, Bodazzler.
Well, hello there, everybody. It is good to have you here tonight at the old Jingle Jam. My name is Oliver. You may know my twin sister, Olive, the other reindeer. She was pretty mean to some reindeers, and so I'm trying to make up for it by having some joy here tonight for our Christmas season, okay? Now, here's what we're going to do. We're going to play a little reindeer game. We're going to need everybody in the crowd to participate in this with us. So, in our reindeer game, it's called One Hoof, Two Hoofs, No Hooves, okay? One hoof, two hooves, or none hooves, all right? That's our game today, and it's very simple. In just a minute, I'm going to ask you to stand up, and you're going to have to choose one hoof, two hooves, or none hooves if you want to be that guy, okay? You want to be that guy with none hooves and play the game with us? Okay, I see, all right? And then I'll spin the wheel, and it'll spin, and it'll tell us who's going to win the game. If you choose the right one on the wheel, then you will continue to play in the game. Does that make sense? Everybody okay with that? Good, good. Everybody's all right? Okay, everybody stand to your feet, please. Here we go, okay? Now, what we're going to need you to do is make your choice, okay? You got a choice between a one hoof or
two hoofs
or the Bah Humbug no hooves, okay? You can choose the Bah Humbug if you want to. If you want to be that guy, go right ahead. That's fine with me, all right? So, are we ready over there? Let's everybody choose our hooves. Everybody make a choice. Make a choice. I'm going to go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Final freeze. All right, let's roll them up there. Here we go. Two hooves, people. Two hooves. All right, I see out there all you two hooves people. Everybody else that did not choose two hooves, park it, okay? Have a seat, please. All right, here we go. All right, all you two hooves people out there, that's nice. That's very nice. You're in the holiday season, okay? So here's what I want you to do. We're going to roll it up again, so I need you to make another choice, either one hoof or two hooves or none hooves and the Bah Humbugs, okay? All right, are you ready? Everybody ready? All right. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, freeze. Make your choice, everybody. And let's roll them up. Okay, here we go. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. I see the none hooves out there. We got the none hooves, the Bah Humbugs out there, okay? You none hooves are moving forward in our game. All right, here we go. Everybody, we're doing good. We're kind of weeding some people out here, okay? So we're just going to keep doing this. We're going to whittle our way down to a few, and then we'll bring a couple of you up here on stage with me, all right? So let's try one more time here. Let's make our choices. One hoof, two hoofs, or the Bah Humbug none hoofs, okay? And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, freeze, and roll them up there. Two hoofs. Who are my two hoofs, people? Who are my two hoofs, people? All right, I see out there. I see everybody, okay? Let's try one more of these before we bring some folks up on stage, all right? One more of these. Everybody that's still standing, you still got a chance at the grand prize winning game, which is something, let me tell you, all right? Okay, so here we go. Choose one hoof, two hoofs, or none hoofs in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Freeze. All right, my good man back there, let's roll him up there. Okay. None hooves. Who are my none hoovers out there? Okay. If you are still standing in the game, I want you to come right up here on stage. Come right on up here on stage. Here we go. Right on up these stairs over here. Look at this little guy. He's got a suit on. He's ready to go. Much like some of my good friends, the Blues Brothers, he's looking sharp tonight. I like it. Okay, we got a handful of people. Okay, just kind of spread out here across the stage. We're going to make all these fine people look at your mugs tonight. Okay, ready? Here we go. Ready? We got some folks up here. Here we go. We got a winter coat warning. We got a winter coat warning up here. Okay, are you cold? Excuse me, young man, are you freezing cold?
Yes.
You're freezing cold. Do you know how cold it is in Chicago right now? It's like negative 47. All right, hey, let's get back to our game here. Okay, ready, all you guys right up here. We got to choose between one hoof, two hoofs, or none hooves, okay? None hooves, okay? Ready, everybody make your selection in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, freeze. All right, roll them up there. Who's still up here? Who's still up here? Okay, head on back to your chair. Thank you, Mr. Wintercoat Man. Okay. Go be warm and well-fed, my friend. Warm and well-fed, okay? All right, here we go. Let's start rolling through them really quick, okay? Ready? Make your selection in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, freeze. Okay, we got them. Two hoofs, one hoof, or none hoof. Okay, ready? Let's roll them. Here we go. Here we go. We got our none hooves. We got our bah humbugs. Okay, who did not choose a bah humbug? You need to go have a seat. Did everybody up here did not have one? Who had a hoof up? Who had a hoof up? Okay, wait. Okay, maybe they didn't understand the name of the game. Okay, so we'll go through this again. We're going to do one hoof, two hooves, or none hooves. Okay, really quickly. You have 3 seconds. Choose now. 3, 2, and 1. Two hooves, none hooves? Okay. Two hooves? Two little hooves. Okay, here we go. Okay. And then a one hoof. We got a one hoof down here. So we got two, 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 two on down the line. Okay, ready? Here we go. Let's roll them up there, please. Okay, here we go. One hoof. We got one hoofers. Okay, go have a seat. The two hoofs, go have a seat. All of you guys down here were two hooves, I believe. We had two hooves. Okay, you guys go have a seat. Thank you very much. You did an excellent job. Excellent job. When we froze, we had yet two hooves, okay? Thank you very much. You did a very good job. Okay, we got four left. Okay, make a selection in 3, 2, 1. What's your selection? One hoof, two hoofs, or none hooves? We got two hooves, none, one? Well, you're going to have to do this. I don't know if you wore deodorant today or not, but we got to get that arm up there nice and tall. I did not wear deodorant today, so I'm kind of smelly. I know. I'm sorry about that. Two hooves, one hoof. Okay. Okay, guys, back there, you still got some more selections to go. Okay, let's go. Roll them up. Two hooves. Thank you very much for playing. You can head on back to your seat. Head on back. Thank you very much. Thank you. All right. You know what, guys? When I lose, that's exactly what I do, okay? You shake that tail feather and move it right along. All right, here we go. Okay, guys, we're down to our final three, okay? Just so you know, every one of you will be receiving a very nice prize today, okay? So let's figure out who's going to be our grand prize winner. And make your selection, please. One hoof, two hooves, or none hooves. One hoof here. One hoof. Well, guys, that's not really going to weed out our game very quickly. None hooves. Okay, we got none hooves right here. And another none hooves. Okay, and one hoof. Okay, let's roll them up there. Roll them up. Here we go. None hooves, okay. Good job, fellas. Okay, here's what we're going to do, okay? No, you stay right up here. Now look at here. You guys did so many rounds. It was like 37 rounds in a row. Very nicely done, gentlemen, okay? So we're going to do this as you're going to be our third prize winner. Very nice job. You're going to be our second prize winner just because you're almost as tall as me. And you're going to be our first place winner. Is that all right? All right. So here's what I got for you. Third place winner, we need you to have some more sugar while you go home, okay? So here's some Hershey candy cane chocolate and peppermint stuff, okay? Very nice job. High five. Thank you very much. Okay, next one. Next one right over here. Okay, you are also going to have some candy cane chocolate. It's my favorite. Wait. And we also have a very stingy bag and a bag of bows for you so you can put a bow on it. Like right there. All right, thank you very much. Give him a very big hand. And then finally, you also get the Hershey candy cane chocolate extraordinaire. And also, this is the best, guys. You're going to love this one. And you get the light up bows. Okay, here we go. Here, turn around. Turn around here. Give him a big smile and say, one hoof, two hoofs, none hooves.
One hoof, two hoof, none hoof.
Attaboy. Thank you very much. You guys have a great time. Make sure you get a lot of joy this Christmas season. We love you. Come back again. All right, see you later.
I don't know. That reindeer looked a little familiar. I don't know who he was, though. I hope Peter was backstage watching that because I know he loves reindeer games. But while we're together for one moment, we're going to talk about joy, okay? Just real quick. So joy is something that I want all of you guys to have tonight before you leave. Hey, Reg.
Yes, my good friend Stephanie. It is I, Reginald Fastidius III, the world's greatest Shakespearean Bible storyteller, reenactor, and part-time angel Christmas tree topper. That's for very large trees, of course.
Of course.
Of course.
That's so... Well, Reg, what are you doing here? We're not even telling a Bible story right now.
My good friend Stephanie, my talents should never be shackled to simply Bible storytelling.
Okay.
They are wild and untamed force that should never be reckoned with. And I shall show you thusly.
Wait. What are you going to show? What are you going to show me?
Oh. Excuse me.
Okay.
You had me in such a twitter, I almost forgot.
Okay. So,
here you are.
Okay. So, the original 12 Days of Christmas.
Yes.
Oh,
yes. So. Stephanie, I was backstage listening, and my good friend Tom, Matthew...
Peter.
Peter. My good friend Peter came out, and he was here, and he was telling of Christmas in his very non-joyous mood and such, and... So I politely informed him that I would come out onto this stage and I would proclamate a tale about something that people typically associate with 2 weeks of joyful gift giving, but rather has a much bleaker, much sadder, very non-joyous beginning.
Okay, so to prove that Peter has some sort of leg to stand on when it comes to being very non-joyous,
right,
as you put it.
Yes.
You're going to sing the 12 Days of Christmas?
Oh, no.
Okay, that's good.
I'm going to have you read it, Stephanie.
Oh, I'm
But I need it. You to read this with gusto.
All right.
I need you to read it with relish and zest.
Okay.
But most importantly, I need you to read this, Stephanie.
Okay. I'm so worried.
With a heartbreaking sadness. Stephanie, I want to find myself weeping.
Wait.
Weeping upon the floor.
Okay. I got it. Do my best.
Now.
Okay.
You may begin.
All right.
Thusly.
Okay. On the 12th day of Christmas...
Remember,
I want to weep. I want to weep upon the floor.
Now continue.
On the 12th day of Christmas.
That is brilliant, Stephanie. That's brilliant. Just like that.
Okay.
Now, continue.
This is never going to end.
Thusly.
Okay. On the 12th day of Christmas, my sad love sent to me 12 drummers depressingly drumming because their dogs ran away.
I drum a solitary drum for the dismal drummer who drummed, drummed, drummed.
Is that really the original verse?
It is, the truth. Now, continue.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now very clear to me how this is all going to go. So I apologize for whatever happens in the next 10 minutes. Please do not hold me responsible. Okay. On the 11th day of Christmas, my sad love sent to me 11 pipers pessimistically piping about their life choices because they all play a flute for a living.
Alms for the poor piper who will never get the job because his name's not Zamfer.
Zamfer? That is just ridiculous. Like, maybe besides Joel Craig, who knows who Zamfer even is?
You all should be ashamed of yourselves. Zamfer is an unappreciated genius of the pan flute.
Okay. Oh, for the love. Okay. Let's speed this up a little bit. On the 10th day of Christmas, my sad love sent to me 10 lords who cannot leap because they broke their legs.
No leaping for this lord. No joy for me, because now I'm bored.
On the 9th day of Christmas, my sad love sent to me... Oh, this should be good. Oh. 9 ladies not dancing because they don't have their dancing shoes. Who wants to see this one? I do. Okay.
There will be no dancing for this dejected girl. There's no way in the world I can ever twirl in these shoes.
Don't encourage him. Okay.
Keep that back here.
On the 8th day of Christmas, my sad love sent to me 8 mates who cannot milk because they are lactose intolerant. Please don't.
No milking.
Reginald.
No milking for the...
Okay, that's good. That's so nasty. Okay. Okay. On the 7th day... that. Okay. I don't even know where I am. Okay. On the 7th day of Christmas, my sad love sent to me 7 swans who decide no longer to swim because they realize they really are ugly ducks.
Oh, why did I have to look? Be gone, mirrors! You truth-telling harbingers!
That was actually a little funny. Okay. On the 6th day of Christmas, my sad love sent to me... Do I have to say this?
Yes.
I don't want to. 6 geese laboriously not laying because they are all stopped up.
I have nothing to say.
Okay. For real? Okay. Come on. Let's get this over with. Okay. 5 melted gold chocolate covered rings.
There is nothing sadder than melted chocolate. Nothing. Nothing.
Okay. Four calling birds who have lost all their contacts and their phones. Three French hens who hate pastries.
No more pastries for you. I spit at thee, patouille.
Two creatures who didn't know if they were a turtle or a dove.
Talk about identity issues.
And a partridge who fell out of the pear tree.
Oh! 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 Stephanie!
Yeah.
Friend! I've fallen and I can't get up!
The merciful end.
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you! You're lovely! You're lovely! You're beautiful! You're gorgeous! Thank you! Thank you, everyone! Thank you! Thank you!
Okay.
Thank you!
So,
thank you!
Wait! Sorry. Wait! So, Reginald, do you really believe in this whole non-joyous Christmas thing?
Heavens no! I absolutely adore Christmas!
Oh.
I'm actually off to a gorgeous sweater party as we speak.
Okay, don't you mean an ugly sweater party?
Heavens no! Who in their right mind would ever wear an ugly sweater?
I don't. Okay.
And I'm off!
Okay.
Thusly!
Okay, thank you. Well, I'm gonna go dry off from all of the water and the spit, and I will be back in just a minute, but we have a music video we want you guys to see from our friends, our Scottish friends, who are a bit more subdued than Reginald, the very funny, the very famous MC Haggis and Seamus McFamous.
Okay, okay, I see what you're doing there. All right, do you think putting real candles on a Christmas tree is smart? Eh? Yeah, I'm talking to you.
Aye.
Oh, well, okay, if that's what you think, then it's... Oh, hey there, I didn't see you there. My name is MC Haggis, and I'm the world's greatest Scottish rapper. When it comes to rhymes, I know a lot. Like, a lot. And back there behind me is the greatest Scottish beatboxer the world has ever known, Seamus McFamous. Say hello, Seamus.
Hey,
give him a taste of what you can do. Woo! And believe you me, there's plenty more where that came from, huh? Oh, oh, see, see, see? So, okay. So now, we are done with the beatboxing samples, please. You're spitting all over the back of my neck. Anyway, Seamus and I are here decorating the Christmas tree, and every year we pick our favorite Christmas decorations, and this year my decoration is a bow. And there's a specific reason why. Well, I'll tell you why. It's because it reminds me of what God's done. At Christmas time, he tells us that no matter what happens, no matter how bad things get, he's gonna put a bow on it at Christmas time by sending his son. So no matter what happens, you can have joy. Isn't that right, Seamus?
Aye.
I knew you'd agree. Okay, it's time to put the bow on the tray. What happened to the tray?
Aye.
I guess putting real candles on it wasn't such a good idea after all. Well, hey, we can still put a bow on it, right?
Aye.
Lovely.
Aye.
I think we should rap about it.
Aye.
Kick it!
Many times we find ourselves upset because of certain toy we did not get. Or maybe someone clogged the guest toilet. But there is something that we can't forget. We can choose to lose a bad attitude. attitude. Try to diffuse the mood that is giving us blues. It's true, I've learned a little trick that I like to use, and I think it's about time that I reveal it to you. I put a bow on it, whatever made me mad. I put a bow on it, if something made me sad. I put a bow on it, it's really kind of fun. I put a bow on it, to remind me that it's good. Put the bow, bow, bow. Rejections and replace it with joyful infection. Here we go. Let me put you in the know. A bow that you know that the future's good to go. So when God said it's on, it was so we would know that when things go wrong, we can know he's in control. Word. Basically, what I'm saying is no matter what happens in this world, God is gonna wrap it up. Playing with the auto-tune. Aye. Right. Let's move on.
That's why I put a bow on it. Whatever made me mad. I put a bow on it. If something made me sad. I put a bow on it. It's really kind of fun. I put a bow on it. To remind me that it's gone. Put the bow.
Guys, I cannot tell you how much joy chocolate combined with peppermint gives me. Let me hear you, am I right? Thank you. I hope Peter feels the same way, because I have another one for him if he comes out here. He's probably backstage avoiding all of this holiday cheer. You know, I actually saw a Salvation Army bell ringer here. He's probably really wigged out.
But I love you, you love me. Christmas is so great, you see, with the lights and the sweets and the big old teddy bears. Let's make sure it lasts all year.
Wow. Yeah, you can clap for that. I don't know. Peter, I thought you were done with all this Christmas joy.
Nope, found some. Hello.
Okay, you seem a little,
Are you saying I'm not joyful?
No, that's not what I'm saying. But wait a minute. Did you eat all of that?
Oh, yeah. And then some. Oh, you told me to.
No, I really didn't. No, I just wanted you to find a little joy.
Oh, I got joy. Boom.
You have got something.
Oh, Stephanie, I own Christmas joy this holiday season, all right? I'm doing it all, okay? I got the outfit, I got the lights, woohoo! I've got, Mr. Gingy Pants, he's so delicious. Oh, and mountains of peppermint ice cream.
Okay, so you're happy. He's crying, he's not happy.
I'm sweaty.
Okay.
Okay, I have a stomach ache, and my eyes, they're like permanently fried from trying to count all the burned out bulbs in this light strand. Red, yellow, blue, green.
Okay.
I hope you're happy.
Okay. I think you're making this a little too complicated. Give me this.
Oh, no. You're stealing my Christmas joy.
Thank you.
Not Gingy Pants.
He will be just fine right there.
No. Here. Oh, no. Stop it.
Do I need to take your lights?
No, not the lights.
Okay. Now, take a breath. How do you feel?
Less sweaty.
Well, that's a good start.
Like I need a Tums.
Oh, like peppermint flavor.
You mock my good cheer.
I'm sorry. This is not exactly how you make yourself joyful. It doesn't actually work that way.
But like Christmas is doomed then.
No, it's not. We are going to talk about joy, and we are going to find a way to make you happy.
But what if the world is just conspiring to make me miserable at Christmas?
Well, then you could know that God's already taken care of all of that.
Okay, so even if the dog ate the Christmas turkey that Mom left on the counter to thaw?
Okay, even that?
You did not see what the dog put in the yard afterwards.
Okay. God did something incredible for us that's bigger than anything that you will ever face. And it's he gave us a gift that in the very end will make everything right again.
Duct tape?
No.
WD-40.
Think this much bigger
amazing.
Than that. Okay.
Okay. Yes. Mr. Gingy Pants.
I'm going to show you. Come on backstage. Okay. He'll be fine. Let's watch this.
This is so delicious.
Yes.
Have you ever wondered what we might see if we could pull back the curtain of time to that very first Christmas? If we could, I imagine the story began in heaven something like this. God was looking over heaven's balcony one day, shaking his head at all the wrong things people were doing down on Earth.
Oh man, this isn't quite what I had in mind when I created Earth. I feel so far away from my kids down there.
Why?
It's just hard to be friends with people when you don't like what they're doing. I think it's time.
Time for what, Lord?
Time for us to step in.
Shall we read as a army, Lord? Can't you see the lesson?
No, I don't think we should send an army. Maybe just one person.
One person?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, if we're sending just one person, it'll have to be someone very powerful and very strong. Because there's tons of people down there.
No, they don't have to be strong. They'll be going as newborn baby.
A newborn baby?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, this plan is rather risky. A newborn human baby is small and weak. This baby must be born to people who protect him. Maybe a great ruler or mighty king?
Actually, I was thinking I could send it to a young peasant girl whose heart is beautiful and full of courage.
A peasant girl?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
My lord, I see you're planning to take Earth by surprise. No one will be expecting a newborn baby born to a humble villager. But what good can a baby do?
This will not just be any baby. I'm sending in the Prince of Heaven in disguise.
The Prince of Heaven? Our prince? Your son?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, this is too risky. Sending the prince in disguise as a tiny baby, born not to kings, but to humble villagers. Surely our prince cannot be born in a cottage. He must be born in a palace.
You're right. He shouldn't be born in a cottage.
Phew.
He'll be born in a stable.
A stable? Surrounded by animals?
Who will hide?
They won't be expecting that!
Lord, how will all the people know he's there? What if they don't notice?
Those who are looking will find him, and his mission will bring all people closer to me, even if they do something really wrong. When the prince is done, nothing will get between them and my love.
Can we leave some clues for the people looking? Like in the stars?
Clues in the stars? Sure, why not? We can make one huge one that points to him.
Can we sing for him?
Yes, can we sing?
Sing to welcome him!
Please say we can sing!
God looked at their hopeful faces, and his heart was touched by their love for the prince.
All right, you can sing.
Yay!
But not in front of the whole world. That would just be weird. And no kings or rulers.
How about we sing for some shepherds?
That's a lonely job.
Those blokes could do with some cheering up.
Brilliant. They won't be expecting that.
You know the rest of the story. An angel visited a humble girl with a courageous heart and told her the good news. She will have a baby and he will be the Prince of Heaven who would help Earth to be close to God again. As planned, the baby was born in a stable, about as far from a palace as you can get. A group of wise men noticed some strange clues in the stars. They packed their belongings and followed the star right to a baby. And of course, a bunch of lonely shepherds were guiding their sheep when all of a sudden the sky was lit up by thousands of angels singing. Nobody would ever expect that.
Unexpected story, right? But we are made and created and loved and serve a great big unexpected God. I want to ask you, have you guys ever prepared like the perfect gift for someone? And you thought of this idea and you're like, they are going to love it. And you saved up your money to buy it, or maybe you actually made this perfect gift and you wrapped it and you put a bow on it and you put it somewhere special. And you were so excited to give it to that person because you knew it was going to bring them so much joy. I want you, maybe that's actually happening right now. Maybe you have something. Don't look to the person next to you, it'll give it away. Keep it up here. But maybe you have something this Christmas to give someone that's super special. But this is exactly how God feels. This is exactly what He did for you. Because Jesus is a gift. And it was a gift that He had been preparing since the beginning of time. And if you were the only one in this room, He still would have put a bow on it for you. And I think that is so important. We don't want you to forget that. Because Jesus is the way that we remember that God loves us and that He forgives us and that He wants us to be with Him forever. And so in order to maybe help you remember that, we have an ornament we want to give your whole family as you leave later on. And maybe you put it on your tree, maybe you put it somewhere else, but we want you to never forget the gift of Jesus. And we're going to do something right now, and we're going to pray, and all the boys and girls who are with me in large group, they know. We close our eyes and bow our heads, and let's go talk to the Lord, okay? Dear God, thank You for this day. Thank You for all of the people who have come here to celebrate You. We are so grateful for the gift of Jesus. God, sometimes things in our life right now may be crazy and we don't understand that You have a plan. But Lord, sometimes even when things are the darkest, we need to remember that You have given us a great light in Jesus. And that sometimes when it's hard to find our joy, we can know that You are going to make everything right again. And You are going to love us because of Your Son. In Jesus' name we pray, and everyone said.
Why don't you all stand with us as we sing one more song, and I'm sure that this is a song that we've all sung many times throughout the season. It's Silent Night. this one nice and loud. We sing just loud. Silent night, wondrous star, led by night, with the angels, let us sing. Hallelujah to our King. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born. You all sound awesome. Thank you. Have a seat.
I guess I kind of get it now. I can still be joyful even when I don't get what I want.
Hearing you say that gives me joy.
Oh, but if I didn't say it?
I see what you're doing. Then I could still have joy because I know what Jesus did for me.
Oh, that's awesome. That's
okay.
Awesome.
Yeah.
You know what? I think we should just slap a bow on this whole night we've had here with everybody and call it a day.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Do you want to do the bottom line real
quick?
Yeah,
let's do that. We'll get that bottom line up one
let's
more
see
time.
If they know
you guys
what joy
ready?
Is.
Can you all do it together?
What is joy?
Ready?
Ready?
Finding a way to be happy,
even when things don't go your way.
Good
yes!
job, guys. Thank you,
you
so much.
You guys are awesome.
Yeah.
So, this is awkward.
Yeah. Is there, like, there's no big finish or anything? No? Okay, so there's no big finish. So, hey, guys, so it's been fun. I hope you guys have a Merry Christmas. Goodbye.
Well, wait,
bye-bye.
Actually,
what?
One moment. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
You're always so fun and exciting, and everybody loves you, and I always have to be the serious pants. Aww. But I prepared something for the end.
You did?
Because I just didn't like how we just made people go.
Oh, yes. This is exciting, guys. Big finish coming up.
actually, it's a solo that I'm going to do. Is that okay?
It's just you?
Yeah.
At the end, like just you, not
that's
me?
How solos work. Yeah, but is that okay? Is it okay? Is that all right with you?
Yeah, that's fine.
You're having joy even when things aren't going your way. I'm so proud of you. Thanks, Peter.
Joyful, joyful Lord, we adore thee. God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before thee. Hail thee as the sun. Fill the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark and doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with a light.
Joyful, joyful Lord, we adore thee.
Come on, come on, get the rest, get the rest.
Come on, come on, come on, come on.
And bow. One more, all right, guys, go that way.
Good job, everybody.
Good, good, good. Big round of applause for our tech crew.
Tech crew.
Our tech crew. How about a big round of applause for our band?
Thank you, band.
Good job.
Good job, guys. Good.
How about a big round of applause for Mr. Peter?
Stop.
How about Miss Stephanie?
And Mr. Ryan Tucker.
Hello.
Don't forget to get your ornaments on the way out. We love you, and you're welcome back this weekend at any of our
refreshments
services.
Are in the gym. Please help yourself. We love
eat.
You. Thanks for coming.
See you later.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.